please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Welcome to Chartbusters. Well, it's a show we're going to highlight all the buzzing stocks. But first things first, here's wishing all the lovely women, all the mummies, the wives, the sisters, the girlfriends, a very, very happy Women's Day to all of y'all, from all of us here on CNBC TV 18, and particularly from the team here on Chartbusters. Well, we've got a market to look forward to in today's trading session. It was a good start, but Mangalam, well, we've moved into the red as we speak. Yes Bank down 5%. Oopsie-daisy.
Oopsie-daisy. Not just Yes Bank. If you take a look at any of these stocks, BPCL as I speak, as we look at it at the low point of the day, we have Hindalco, Sun Pharma, Tata Motors, all of them currently at the low point of the day. So here's wishing a happy Women's Day to Lady Market as well, yeah. Perhaps. Lady Luck.
Maybe Lady Luck, yeah.
Lady Luck, Lady Wealth and Lady Markets. But first up, all the top stories that we're tracking at this point in time. Power Minister R.K. Singh says that SBI is worried about the loans it has extended to the projects of Adani and Tata Power. In an exclusive, the SBI management clarifies to CNBC TV 18 and says that power is a stress sector, not just for SBI, but for the whole banking system itself.
And CNBC TV 18 exclusive news break is confirmed. The Cabinet approves restructuring of deferred spectrum payments, also gives its nod to e-spectrum holding limits for telecom firms.
Race for Bhushan Steel closes in. Tata Steel's bid, formally identified as the highest evaluated compliant resolution for Bhushan Steel.
And Amtek Auto surges in trade. Liberty House chosen as the preferred H1 bidder for Amtek Auto.
And Fortis, that stock is in focus, out of F&O ban today, off the high point as we speak. All right, and as we speak, just keep an eye out on a couple of these sugar stocks. They've been under pressure for a very long time. Looks like the world's perhaps going on a diet. But Balrampur Chini down about 11% as we speak. Take a look at Dwarikesh. And we understand that maybe sugar prices are lower also because the ISMA targets that came in as far as production is concerned, that was much higher. So higher supply, not too good for the sugar companies. Oops. Dwarikesh also down about 8%. A lot of wealth destroyed there. In fact, over the last 1-2 years, there was a lot of wealth made there. Absolutely. As well. And then from there on, we've seen that decline in all those sugar stocks. But let's take a look at what Ashwani has to say about the markets as well and the sugar stocks. Ashwani, the opening pop was sold into. We're virtually at the low point of the day in the red. How much lower can we go? And sugar stocks, what's your view there?
Well, one woman certainly is not happy. And it's looking to break its 200-day moving average. And the warning there is that all hell will break loose if we lose another 10 points on the Nifty. And the way it's going, ICICI Bank was opened up 3%. Right. Now it's up only 1%. Chances are the Bank Nifty expiry will only accentuate this move. So that way people shouldn't be long, because the bounce that we got from the Nifty 200 also hasn't really sustained. So my sense is that the afternoon could be fairly interesting. As far as Balrampur Chini is concerned, you know, this is what will happen once any sort of commodity cycle changes, because the markets often tend to come down 3 times as fast as they went up. So sugar is out. As far as individual stocks are concerned, now private banks are falling 4-5%. So Yes Bank, I think, is breaking down. That's a sell with a stop of 302, target of 286. REC is a sell with a stop of 134, target of 122. And maybe Sonata Software you can buy with a stop of 306, target of 321.
Well, Ashwani, you know, definitely today Lady Luck is shining on the bears for sure. You know, today's gap up was a perfect opportunity to go ahead and short. But a lot of traders out there, they're asking, when can we see a short covering bounce? You know, Ashwani, on a day-to-day basis, you've been talking about selling the Nifty. Where can be there some kind of support at 10,000, at 9,800? How deep, how low can we go?
You're asking the wrong question. When we were going up, by asking every day, when will a correction come in? Did you get a correction? Similarly, when you are going down, you've seen the bounces. Today was a perfect opportunity, great global cues, everything great. We were standing at support. But look at the selling that comes in, even when you get a 50-point gap up. So it's fairly clear that the 200-day moving average will break down.
Correct.
And we will maybe even break 10,000. So don't worry about short covering rally. It will come only once this FII selling and this LTCG selling, etc. is done. I think March will be a fairly bad month. So people need to prepare for that, because you know, this is really becoming a technical issue where some people have decided we are getting out, period. All the stocks they own are, you know, large private banks or, you know, Reliance, etc. If, you know, large stocks come off, market will go down. So, you know, they don't care if global queues are up. In fact, they use that opportunity to sell even harder.
All right. That's some big statements coming from you, Ashwani. The Nifty likely to break 10,000 as well. But, you know, you've been talking to us daily and you've been talking to all our viewers. But just today, one idea that you have to give to all the women traders who are watching. Men, please tune out. One out of syllabus question for the women traders for today.
One idea that can change your life?
a stock idea.
Well, go short on Yes Bank. It may change your life because it has further to fall.
Continues with the mid-cap space. That index is down about 245 points as we speak. HDIL should come up for you. That one's taken a bit of a pummeling. Huge volumes out there. The stock has suddenly taken a knock at the low point of the day. HDIL is the one that I'm talking about. But that's as far as the losers are concerned. Keep an eye out on one stock that has bucked this trend and how. Just this month itself, it's up 21%. Over the last 1 year, up by almost 2.5 times. That is V-Mart Retail, and moving high with great volumes as well. So if you take a look at the monthly chart, 12 months, it's up 170%. So that's about 2.7 times. V-Mart Retail, that is the stock. So what exactly is happening in the company? Well, we have Lalit Agarwal who joins us to tell us more. Lalit, you know, in a market so weak, your stock is moving towards record highs and with huge delivery volumes. I was just looking at some delivery stats on the exchange. So if you could tell us, what exactly is happening with the company? Institutions hold about 33% stake in your company. What sort of fund action, HNI action, investor action, anything that you're aware of? What explains this sort of move?
Yeah, hi. So we have been blessed with good investors, and the market has understood our story well. And I really thank and have sense of gratitude to each and every person who has met us and understood us. So great news, and I think it's not about V-Mart story, it's about the India story. And we have been just trying to focus on that Bharat story, which is primarily in this small town. And so we are bang on and focused on our approach to service those customers last and try to give them the best of the quality services. So we have been getting good responses from investors abroad, and most of the FII people who want to understand Indian consumer market are taking this story very nicely, and they have been understanding. They have been really meeting us for the last 2-3 years, and now they have got the trust that we are the people who are going to deliver it. And we are making sincere efforts and sincere capability building in the back end to try and do this.
All right. You know, Mr. Agarwal, I just want to make a quick point. I remember last year there was so much of talk about DMart, and people subscribed over there. They made good money as well. The stock had listed at nearly double on DMart. But V-Mart as well, that's been a near three-bagger in the last 1 year. So your investors would be very, very happy, Mr. Agarwal. But now let's get to what's coming up. You know, is there some kind of inorganic acquisition that you're looking at? Because the street is sensing something. It's clear. Day to day, we are seeing all the stocks being sold off. But V-Mart, you know, there's clearly a lot of interest over there. Is there some kind of inorganic acquisition that could be on the card, sir? And even if that's not the case, tell us, what is the cash that you have in the books, or how does your balance sheet look like?
Yeah, so we have been always, you know, last 2-3 years, we have been free cash flow positive, and we have been trying to grow with our own internal accrual, and we haven't raised any debt, and we haven't raised any money from the market also post our IPO. So we have good amount of cash. We are right now debt free, and we have net surplus cash of maybe more than 500 million. So we would
Can
want to grow
more. Can you repeat the cash number, Mr. Agarwal?
So we have 50 crores cash on our books.
50 crores, okay.
Yeah. So we want to grow. We want to see. We see a lot of organic opportunity right now, because there's a lot of scope into the towns where we are operating. We recently tried tier 4 towns, and those tier 4 towns, 3-4 towns, we experimented, and all those towns are doing good. So that throws a huge opportunity for us to grow into 3-4,000 towns in India. So there is an opportunity organically also. But yes, the organization can only grow to a certain extent. So we are open. I think, I don't know, but we are open to look at any kind of opportunity coming up. Not too many.
Are you talking to any PE investors, Mr. Agarwal?
No, why should I be talking? I don't need any money.
Okay, no. Because you said you are open to any sort of, you know, acquisition. Tell you what, in the retail space, last couple of years, they've seen a lot of deals. There was the Future Bharti deal. Then Future Group, in fact, has been on an acquisition spree. They bought the Heritage business, Heritage Foods retail business as well. And we understand a couple of retail companies are on the block right now. Are you looking at any of them and maybe committing at looking at them and getting some support coming in from PEs as well? Because 50 crores is the cash that you have in your books.
Yeah, I can understand and sense and understand what you are talking. But no, I don't think we are too much interested in all those. So we are doing our business. We are focusing on that. We are not talking to any PE. But we are actively someone who comes up and someone who wants to talk to us and someone who wants to speak to us. We are always open to understand, open to look at other businesses because we operate in a cluster. Mm. You would like to understand other clusters. You would like to understand some regional clusters, some retailers who are there in other clusters. We are always ready to understand and listen and also debate over this.
Are you buying Vishal? Are you talking to them?
No. So we haven't been actively there. So we have heard a lot of things about it. It is something which I had founded early 1999. Mm-hmm. So we were together when Ramchandra Agarwal and me had founded. So, but it is a very good asset. But yes, it is too large for us to understand.
Okay. So as of now, you here on our show on Chartbusters, you're telling us that you're not looking at it as of now.
No, we are not.
Okay, great. Let's take that point forward then, sir, in terms of organic growth. You said you can grow organically to a particular extent. Currently, I believe the total number of stores you have is around 160, 170, and you've added nearly around 30 stores in this financial year. What kind of a number are you looking at, going to, sir, in terms of an organic growth? And if that's the case, at some point of time, you'll require some money, right? So will you come to the markets to raise some money?
So you're absolutely right. See, we will not hesitate with the growth. We have opened 30 stores in this year. We will want to open up at least 35 stores in the coming year also, or maybe more than that as the opportunity comes in. And as of now, the kind of profitability what the company has, we'll be able to manage. But still, if we need it, we don't have any debts on our books. We would like to have some debt on our book to make our return on equity a little more healthier. So we would still want to understand more about this because our business is throwing money. And we would want to use that money to grow.
So if you're given an option between equity and debt, what will you raise, sir?
So as of now, because company doesn't have any debt on the books, we would want to have some debt on the books if required.
Okay.
But yes, if there's a larger need, then we will want to go to equity. And company has always relied on equity. We have had a policy that we will not go anytime beyond 0.5x of our debt-equity ratio.
All right. And finally, no inorganic growth that we can expect in the next 6 months or this financial year?
I want you guys to propose me something here. Why not?
Vishal is on the street. You know, there are reports all over the newspapers. So
tell us something we don't know, sir.
No. As of now, nothing is happening yet. You'll be the first person knowing it. Don't worry.
Absolutely. Well, Bid Women's Day today, we have a special guest joining us on the show, the director of Sankh Industries, Ms. Bina Engineer. Well, good morning, ma'am. Thanks so much for joining in and wishing you a very happy Women's Day first. But let's talk about Sanghi Industries, ma'am. We have some news as well overnight. So tell us about this NCD issue that you'll have come out with. 256 crores is what you'll have raised. If you could give us a sense of why you're raising this, I believe you're looking to refinance some of that some older debt. So what was your borrowing cost and what will be the new rate?
Yes, in 2016 we had raised NCD at 15.5% for the equal amount, and we had a prepayment option in March 18. So by raising this new 256 crore NCDs, we have redeemed the old NCDs. The old NCDs were carrying a cost of 15.5%. New NCDs are carrying a coupon of about 10.5%.
All right. So net to your savings.
So primarily the objective was to redeem.
Go ahead, ma'am.
Yes, primarily the objective was to redeem the existing debt, and this is not an additional debt.
Okay, so you'll save 5% on 256 crores, so that means savings of roughly 3 crores per quarter on interest expense?
That's right.
Alright, so now that you've raised the money to repay existing debt, you also earlier had done a QIP, you have strong capacity expansion plans. Are you well funded for all those plans, or will you be looking to raise more debt or more equity going forward?
No, we are absolutely totally funded for our expansion project, and we would have significant amount of surplus that would still stay with us during the course of implementation of next 2 years for the expansion. The expansion was 1250 crores. We raised 800 crore of term loan and we raised 400 crore of QIP equity. So that completely provides for the expansion project, and we have very scattered and very insignificant amount of outflow towards the existing debt repayment over next 2 years. So we'll also generate large cash surplus during next 2 years, which we'll retain till the project is completed as a buffer.
All right, ma'am, quick two questions then. What is the total debt in your books currently? If you could tell us what's that number? And when does this capacity expansion that the street is waiting for, when does this doubling of capacity come on stream? 2020, can we work with that number?
Yes, April 2020 is the targeted date of commissioning.
Okay.
It is typically 2 years of implementation period. And the current debt on the book is about 650 crore, including working capital.
Okay, and before we let you go, ma'am, your FY18 sales targets were 3 million tons. Are you on course to achieve that? And what is your FY19 sales volume targets?
So FY18, in the current quarter, we had a small maintenance program which was unanticipated earlier. That's why there could be some drop in volume. So I don't want to predict at this stage, but we anticipate some drop in volume because of that maintenance program. FY19, we are still on course, so we are looking at about somewhere around 3.2-3.3 million ton volumes in FY19.
Okay, all right. Thanks so much, ma'am, for stopping by and in fact giving us those details. I think in fact you have been a good luck charm. You know, in the last 10 minutes odd, the market has recovered as well. The Nifty moves higher as we speak. Thanks so much for joining in. Well, as we wind down on Chartbusters, let me take this moment to recognize and appreciate all